Hello, VibraDeco's here again, and LuridSilence, back with another Pokemon Spyro Dawn of the Dragon version.
But, wait. Ravioko's here, that means this is a versus.
Yeah!
No, it doesn't.
Hold on.
But...
this is not that...
But I'm gonna win! I'm gonna win!
No, I'm gonna
Phew.
Win.
Phew, I won Yoshi's Island versus... Hey, look, a green thing.
A green thing?
I won Yoshi's Island versus... I'll win this, too.
Nuh-uh.
Mark my words.
You suck.
I missed. I do
you,
suck.
You missed and you dragged me down with you, you asshole.
Where are you going?
I was trying to go over here.
I can't move. Why can I not move to the left? I cannot. There we go.
What the hell? I pressed circle.
No, you didn't.
Yeah.
See, this isn't the kind of game that you can do a versus of unless you have, like, two separate teams.
That'd be cool.
It would be.
Yay! I finally got more magic.
It would be like a multiverses.
It'd be like a foursome versus. No, you know what it would be? It wouldn't be versus.
It would be an orgy versus.
Cause Raven didn't know what that meant. I get the joke. Am I cool now?
We are not even 2 minutes into the episode, and we're bringing this up. Not only that,
we're
bringing it up less than 2 minutes into the episode, but you stole my joke, because I was about to make that joke.
We have to mention it in every single Let's Play, and we haven't mentioned it in this one yet.
Because you haven't been here.
Maybe we should... Okay, yeah, like, that stopped you in the past.
It hasn't. We've talked about it without him.
And then I watched the episode, and I'm just kind of like, fuck you guys. I didn't know.
We know you didn't know. That's what's funny.
Oh, yeah, well, what's my middle name?
Ravioko?
No.
Is it Joe?
No. See, you don't
know
things.
Is it beautiful?
No, it's Joseph.
Oh.
You forgot this.
I was close.
You forgot this. It's like you're making a really good dinner, and you're like, you forgot this.
Sorry.
We have to be slightly fat.
I was close enough.
No, you weren't. Don't lie to me.
Danielle, this way.
Okay, that way.
Yeah, this way. Stop flying!
Why?
Because you're gonna fall off of something and drop your balls!
I don't want my balls to drop.
Exactly.
I don't want to spawn balls and have them drop.
It would be pretty cool if you did that,
yeah,
though.
Shit.
That'd be impressive.
We need to go this way.
Wouldn't.
It'd be impressive that you could pull that off.
No.
Yes.
It would not be.
I think it would be.
Okay.
I made some wicked good ravioli earlier, and I took a picture of it.
I made ravioli a few days ago. It was really good.
You should call it Ravioki.
Ravioki? That would make more sense if I had made eggs.
No.
Yeah, ravioki.
Yeah.
But ravioli, ravioki.
It doesn't have the same ring to it.
Don't shoot down my cleverness.
Also, if I send a picture of the ravioli, can it be edited in, like, right around here? Just like,
yeah.
Yes! I'm gonna send you the picture.
Okay.
And you have to edit it in.
Fine.
Right now. There it is. It's my ravioli.
Looks delicious, doesn't it?
Thank you.
We're not even gonna put it right here.
You just made the whole audience want ravioli.
Thank
Ravioki!
It sounds dumb.
I'm gonna start up a
sounds dumb.
I'm gonna start up a cooking show and just call it like everything I make is gonna have to have Ravioko in there somehow. I gotta Danielle.
What are you
help
doing?
Me out.
How we don't
I
need
say
to do
pizza?
That yet.
Because the other day I cooked pizza.
Go get your balls. Notice.
I need a Ravioko plus pizza kind of thing. Ravikizza.
Ballet. Oh, I have
Pizzioco,
her song.
Pizzioco, there we
Ballet!
Go.
Pizza what?
Pizzioco. For pizza and ravioco.
That's really dumb.
Ow, 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 ow.
Do we need to fight these guys?
No.
Yes.
Yeah.
You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna play this.
What are you
gonna
do?
I'm gonna play the Smash Bros. 3DS demo.
Cool.
It's a good demo.
Danielle, I'm gonna die.
You probably are.
They should put Spyro in the next Smash Bros.
He's not a Nintendo character.
Oh yeah, because really Pac-Man and Mega Man and Sonic and Solid Snake are totally Nintendo characters, Zach. Great
Solid
fucking
Snake
eye.
Was, Solid Snake was the guest. So was Mega Man, and Pac-Man was bought by Nintendo.
No, he wasn't.
Yes, he was.
No, he wasn't.
That's why all the Pac-Man World games are by Nintendo.
Okay, no. Are you being serious right now? Pac-Man was not bought by Nintendo. Nor was any of the guest characters, because you left out Sonic, who was also not Nintendo.
Yeah, they actually don't belong to Nintendo.
Sonic is technically Nintendo now, because...
No, he's not.
Sega was bought by Nintendo.
No, they were in a partnership to make three games for Nintendo exclusive, but that doesn't mean Sega's owned by Nintendo.
Yeah, Sega's not owned by Nintendo. They just have games published
they had a partnership.
On Nintendo consoles.
Did Sega... Wasn't... Okay, Sega failed after a while.
Yeah.
Yes.
And Nintendo bought them.
No. Sega's just not making consoles anymore.
Okay, then what was it that Nintendo did for Sega?
They allowed them to publish.
Yeah.
And then what you might be thinking of was recently Nintendo and Sega had a contract that was like the next three Sonic games are on Nintendo consoles.
See, the thing is, Raven, you actually look into this stuff. Zach doesn't.
Oh, I fucking...
I was told Danielle,
let me clarify. I don't look into this stuff. I make this stuff. I am secretly the CEO of both Sega and Nintendo, and no one fucking knows it.
I don't think
except everyone that watches this now knows it.
I think you just look into this stuff and know more about it.
To go back to an earlier point.
I can't.
Pac-Man is also not Nintendo.
Why can't I not move?
I don't know. I was having the same issue earlier.
Okay, now I can move. Anyways, yeah. I mean...
Oh, shit.
It would make more sense for any of those characters to be in Brawl than it would for Spyro to be in Brawl.
Right. No, I get that. There are, you know, like, most of the time, there are very few third-party characters that I legitimately want in Smash Brothers. Like, I've wanted Mega Man since Melee, so you can imagine my excitement when the initial trailer came out. Sonic, you know, he deserves it because of the whole Sega-Nintendo rivalry. Pac-Man, I would say he deserves it because he's kind of just like... He's Pac-Man. And Snake, to me, has always been the grumpy uncle of Smash Brothers. But there is one character who's third-party. It's by an indie publisher that I would really love it if they were in Smash Brothers.
I don't mean to interrupt you, Raven, but the first time we did this, it took us so fucking long to figure this out, and I don't know why. Like...
Because there's no instruction of how to do it.
Yeah, like, we figured out that you could grab onto the boat and all that, but we had no idea how to do it. We even tried, like, using the wind power to blow the boat.
Didn't work,
blow the boat.
Turn the whale, turn the whale, turn the whale!
You tried blowing the boat?
Yeah.
We tried blowing the boat.
Yeah, hey, boat! Yeah!
You tried blowing the boat.
Yes, Raven. We tried blowing the boat.
Yes.
You know what game is spooky scary?
What?
Amnesia.
You don't say.
I finished it earlier, and it was incredibly spooky scary.
You still have to go watch that one by Mark.
I will, but I need recovery time.
Yeah.
I got all three endings, because I'm that dedicated.
Okay, I forgot I can't go down that path.
Not very many Let's Players actually go and get, like, all the endings in a blind Let's Play.
Well, the only reason I did is because I knew how to... There's three. I knew how to get all of them, and there was, like, an autosave in the last room, so...
Right.
And, like, the first ending I got didn't satisfy me. The second ending I got satisfied me a bit more, but I was still kind of like, no. And then the third one, I was like, I like this ending. This one's mine.
Pirouette!
It's probably because you got, like, the bad ending, the okay ending, and then the good ending.
I got... The first ending I got was the bad one, where you die. The second one I got was where you die, but you, like, threw that guy's head into the thing, so he, like... I was getting the impression he was bringing me back to life by some god or something. And then the third one I got was where you fucking, like, killed Alexander, and then you just fucking left.
Yeah, I died. And I didn't even get to throw their heads in a thing.
I really like the new Smash Brothers.
I like what I've played of it, but I've only played the demo.
Well, yeah, I mean,
I
like,
have not
yeah.
played anything, like, because I don't want spoileries.
It's a demo. How?
It's just a demo.
Yeah, it's... What else is there to spoil? Like, the game's out.
You already know everything that they've revealed, right. So...
Yeah,
the only thing that could possibly spoil it for you is, like, if you go online and look at all the newcomers and stuff that weren't officially announced, but the Japanese game is out, so everyone knows them. Those aren't in the demo, so...
Yeah, there's no spoilers in the demo.
Right.
Like, yeah, there's nothing in the demo you don't know.
Have you gone and looked at all the characters that are out in the Japanese version?
Yes, I know everyone that's in the Japanese version. The game's already been data mined.
The only thing I want to ask... is, did they release, Jigglypuff and Ness?
Yes.
I thought so.
Yeah, like, it was pretty obvious that was gonna happen.
Yeah.
But they data mined the game.
It would be kind of blasphemous if it didn't.
And there's a lot of hints of DLC in the game's code. So...
Like, character DLC?
Both characters and stages.
See, stages I can understand, not characters. I don't think characters should be a DLC.
Why not, out of curiosity?
Because that's not something you should do in a game.
Because, like, that's an example of that you didn't buy the whole game the first time, you only bought some of it, and then you have to make extra purchases to get the rest of the game.
Okay, but it's... Okay, I see what you're saying, because that's what a lot of companies do, but I'm not talking... They've set it up that if they ever, you know, when the game's finished and they're as an afterthought, like, oh, we could do this, they've set it up that that would be a possibility. There's, like, placeholder data that isn't specified for, like, oh, you're gonna get... I'm not gonna say who came to mind, because I'm sure that would throw up some sort of debate. You're gonna get fucking... Pika Ash Ketchum.
Pika Ash Ketchum.
Yeah, it's not like it's
that,
not like
is that Ash
characters.
Ketchum from that one episode where he turned into a Pikachu?
Yeah, that's it's not like, oh yes, these characters are in the game and you just have to buy them. It's like, if they ever want to make DLC, like a year down the road, Sakurai gets an idea, they've set it up where
hey, this
will
be a cool character
to do it.
Well, also, there's been a huge amount of character mods for Smash Bros.
Right.
Brawl.
Right.
And when you mod that game, though, they locked it down so hard last time so that anytime you modded in a character, you had to replace an old character. Where is the boat?
They fixed that. The Brawl modding community has gotten so far you can get around that and just add in brand new characters.
Yeah, I know, but I feel like that empty character data that they have in the game could be to help modders like that.
I suppose, but I doubt a game company is like, yes, let's promote modding of our...
Minecraft does.
Okay, but that's an
indie
Minecraft
game. This is Smash Brothers.
And even
that's
then,
like
now that Minecraft kind
of
belongs to Microsoft, I doubt that's going to happen as much.
Right,
I mean,
but I'm just saying,
Minecraft, they even
like,
came out and said, was made for modding.
Exactly.
Yeah. But, you know, what I'm trying to say is, they're trying to not discourage it, because all modding does is get their game out more.
Well, true, but they're an indie game developer. The point being, Nintendo, more specifically, as he has a reputation for being incredibly stubborn about these sort of things, Mashed Potato Samurai isn't... It's just an easier way to pronounce his name for me. Isn't going to be like, yes, here, there is space here, so you can mod my game. It's
not something he would do.
Yeah.
Right. Like, he has a reputation.
Yeah,
for being
I guess this
stubborn.
Is the guy that took out the subspace mode so that. Because, you know,
so that
he didn't like the cutscenes being on fucking YouTube.
Exactly. All I'm saying is, it's like, there's dummy data.
Yeah.
So it's like, if they ever... For me, DLC, it's okay if it's like an afterthought. If the game is done, and there's extra space, and they're like, you know what? This game's been out for a few months, but I just got this great idea. It also might be when the Wii U version comes out, it'll be like an update on the 3DS version.
I just think if a DLC adds a new experience to the game, then that's fine. But like, a character is something that like
that should be included in the game when you buy it.
So like, if you play online and you don't have the DLCs, some other guy may have the DLC, and like, so then he has this character that you can't play as, and it's just basically a giant cock tease.
Right, I
get
that.
But, like, with a map, you wouldn't be able to play on that map online because you don't have it. So it's, like, it's, you know.
I get what you're saying. For me, you know, I don't want it to be, like, oh, yeah, pay $15 for this character. But if it's, like...
Like, I could see in the future if maybe they released a new character for free...
Well, that's most likely.
Or maybe, like, if they are going to do DLC, maybe make, like, new characters, like, $1.99 or something like
that,
you know?
It certainly wouldn't be expensive.
Right,
there are a few theories floating around as to how this is all going to play out, and I'm not sure. The first and most obvious one being, oh, it's just going to be regular DLC.
Yeah, I believe so.
Shouldn't we check?
Yeah.
Sorry, Raven, go on.
Another one being, on the even in the demo of the 3DS, you can't access it in the demo, but there is, like, a connect to Wii U, and it's already promised that the character rosters are going to be the same in both, but some people some people are saying they need a way to hype the Wii U version so they could have characters in there and then just an update for the 3DS once that comes out, which could be what the dummy date is for.
I
sort of don't agree with that, but I do acknowledge they do need a way to keep the hype up for the Wii U version for people who aren't automatically like, I need that game. Because some people are only planning to get the 3DS version, and obviously they want the other version to sell.
Right.
And as great as awesome new stages are, new stages, you know, isn't exactly the most hype-worthy of things.
Right. I guess I can see maybe if they add a few characters into the Wii U, as long as you can get them for free on the 3DS
exactly.
Once you buy the Wii U version.
Yeah,
like, I could see that. That would be fine.
If there's DLC for Smash Brothers and it's not, like, cross-compatible, like, oh, you buy the Wii U version DLC and you get the 3DS version, then I'd be kind of pissed, because it's like, I'm not paying twice for the same thing.
Yeah.
It's like... If you have to pay for it, it should be one payment for both. I'd prefer it just be, like, a free update. Some people are saying maybe a free update for, like, a month or two, and then after the month or two, it starts to be, like, oh, you gotta pay $5. And then maybe suck my dick. I don't know. The point being...
Maybe.
The point being, there is dummy data in the game, and proof that if they ever decide to do DLC... Which, after Mario Kart 8, it's proved that Nintendo isn't exactly against DLC, then they might do it.
What all DLC did Mario Kart 8 do? Didn't it do, like, Legend of Zelda, Mercedes-Benz, and then, like...
It did Mercedes-Benz, Link, Animal Crossing Villager, Isabelle from New Leaf, a bunch of different Yoshi colors... I think a bunch of different Shy Guy colors, and that might mean they just added in Shy Guy.
Yeah, no, I remember that now. If you buy the bundle pack that has...
Right, they have a bunch of
both
stuff.
Of the sets of DLCs, you get the Yoshi and the Shy Guy colors.
They have, Tanuki Suit Mario. I think there's one I'm missing that I don't remember. Oh, they have, I think, like an F-Zero Captain Falcon go-kart.
Mm.
Which, to me, that's kind of the nail in the coffin for F-Zero right there. Because Mario Kart 8 sort of stole
it. I don't know, I feel like that could help promote it more at the same time.
Well, I guess, but it's like F-Zero and Mario Kart were sort of separated by, like, F-Zero is zero gravity, and now Mario Kart's zero gravity, so... I mean, they could continue with F-Zero, and I'd be happy if they did, but I don't see it happening.
Not to cut you off or anything, Raven, but we need to go quickly. There's things dying.
Be safe. You should probably go save some lives.
Aren't we supposed to get the water?
Yeah, but aren't we supposed to, like, talk to him first?
I don't think so.
Okay. This way, then. Help! Help! Please! Oh, go ahead, Raven.
I'm kind of done. You didn't cut me off. I was just finishing.
Oh, okay.
I mean, I could talk about the new Smash all fucking day, but... surprisingly, this is the first Smash game... Well, I mean, there is, like, one thing that disappoints me, but I'm not really disappointed in any aspect of this game. The only thing that disappoints me is that the ice climbers don't return, but I can understand why.
They don't?
They don't return because the 3DS can't handle both of them at once.
Because, that makes sense.
As you may or may not know, the 3DS right now, I mean the new 3DS will be able to do it better, but the 3DS right now can barely handle Smash Brothers. It runs the game smoothly.
Yeah.
But, you know, if you go to access the home menu, it takes longer than usual. You can't use Miiverse or anything while playing Smash Brothers, and if you quit the game, you have to restart the entire system. So, personally, I'm impressed they got it to work without any issues. But,
yeah, I was kind of wondering about that, too. That, like, you know, that game is going to take a heavy toll on the 3DS.
Like, naturally, it'll be a little easier to run on the new 3DS because of the new CPU and all that jazz. But I'm a little disappointed the Ice Climbers didn't return. There's some unfinished Ice Climber data in the game, but they just couldn't get them both to work on the 3DS. Which is understandable. Because imagine, like, four players all playing as Ice Climbers.
Shit.
Like, that just... It wouldn't work. So that's a little disappointing, because even though I never played as them, they were kind of adorable.
That works, too.
Right. But other than that, there's like nothing that disappoints me with the game, which is kind of makes me sad because a lot of people are really disappointed with the final roster.
Are they?
Yeah, they're did.
Really?
I mean,
they added so many characters.
I know, like, I don't want to spoil it for you, Zach, but there's like, there's these two specific.
How many more new characters outside of Shulk or past Shulk were there? I want to know how many, characters? Not what they were. Yeah.
New characters, like brand new or characters. Just like. If I'm recalling correctly,
two. Unannounced. Two?
Well, unannounced characters, that's... let me think. I think three.
Okay, so two new characters.
No. Seven, including Ness and Jigglypuff.
Okay.
If we're talking newcomers, two.
Okay.
But one of those two newcomers and one returning character people consider the roster to be, like, ruined because of those two characters, which pisses me off because one of those characters I'm really happy is in.
Okay, you know what? Just go ahead and tell me.
Okay, Duck Hunt
Where
Dog
is
in.
Water?
The water's over there, but we need to light those torches first. Anyway, yeah. Continue, sorry.
Duck Hunt Dog is in.
What?
Yeah, Duck Hunt Dog.
That's...
It's
weird.
It's weird, but it's actually really nice. Like,
yeah,
they,
I mean, like
he's kind of like a reimagining of Snake's moveset on Duck Hunt Dog. It's him and a dog. Like he has a duck as a helper.
Yeah, that's weird, but like that's not ruining of the game.
Wait, that's not one of
that
the ones
actually
that
makes
it.
More sense to me than Little Mac.
That makes more sense than Little Mac or Pac-Man actually.
Right, well, Duck Hunt Dog
that
isn't
was an
one of the
NES
ones that
game.
The game. I'm gonna save the two that quote-unquote ruined the game for last.
Oh, okay.
Rob is back.
Okay, yeah.
Ness and Jigglypuff told you about. Game & Watch
Rob
back.
Was an actually interesting character to play as.
I liked using Rob. He was kind of difficult, but also
cool.
Really cool.
Okay, so
his
that's
Final Smash
so far.
Is a lot better. I think I missed one when I gave you a number. The one I missed, Bowser Jr. is in.
Oh, that's cool!
Awesome, confirmed.
And all he doesn't have any palette swaps. He just plays as the different Koopalings. So, like,
actually really cool.
He's like the way he works is he's constantly in the little clown car thing, and that has two like arms. I'm both happy he's in and sad because I originally wanted him
in. Because of the Shadow Mario thing.
Yeah. I originally wanted him in Brawl because he could transform into Shadow Mario, but the game doesn't have any transformations anymore. His final smash, he turns into Shadow Mario, but only for like a brief second. And it doesn't
Wait, who? Bowser Jr.?
Yeah.
Oh.
But it doesn't make much sense if you're playing as one of the other Koopalings, because then it's like, that's not how that goes. But he's cool. A funny thing about him is his, like, regular B attack is a cannon. And so if you swallow him as Kirby, the cannon comes out of Kirby's mouth. And it's the weirdest looking thing. Ganondorf is back.
Yeah, I already knew about him. He was announced a long time ago.
He was?
Yeah,
he was.
Oh. Huh, I missed that then.
He was one of, like, the first, I think, 24 that were...
Really?
Yeah.
Well, there you go. I don't think I'm forgetting anyone. So the two that ruined the game, I don't think they ruined. The first one, and the one that I don't really care that people dislike, is Dark Pit, who's a clone of
Dark
Pit.
Oh, hey! He was kind of, like, half-released
exactly.
in one of the things.
Yeah.
So, like... Yeah, I mean, I don't see why that ruins
the
game.
Well, the reason people don't like Dark Pit and the next one I'm going to match is because they're clones. Like, Dark Pit's moveset is essentially Pit's moveset. He just has different attributes. The second one, who I plan to main, and I'm really sad everyone dislikes him, is Dr. Mario.
Oh, yeah, I heard about Dr.
People
Mario.
People dislike that?
People dislike him because they're like, it's Mario with a different down B. For me, it's like, it's pre-Brawl Mario. I've wanted this. Don't ruin it for me.
Yeah.
Why does that matter? Please.
I don't know.
I really don't care about clones being added in. That's not necessarily a bad thing.
Right.
Yeah.
It's
like,
kind of more like you're just picking a different skin, sort of.
Yeah, nobody right. ever complained about, you know, Pichu being a clone of Pikachu that just damaged
True.
Itself.
But that was like... It's mostly the competitive people that are like, I want the roster slot to be a new character and not someone who has a copy of a moveset. Back
they've
in,
already got
you know, like
so
back then,
many
yeah,
characters.
They've
like,
put
no, I know,
so
I'm,
many characters out.
I know.
And so many characters that people never would have expected. Like, Shulk? Like, I mean, I myself don't really care about the Xenoblade series, but
I don't think
it's a cool addition.
No, yeah, like, I expected Shulk. I didn't expect myself to like him as much as I do. I really want to play as him. But
Robin
never...
is a really cool addition.
Robin is cool. They should
the female
Robin
Marth
Raven,
that I can't remember the name of.
Lucina?
Yeah.
Yeah. She's a Marth clone, though, but I like her.
The only really new characters that I didn't like being added in were Little Mac and Pac-Man, just because they don't... They were
Little
literally
Mac,
just, like, advertisements for their new games.
Well, yes and no.
Because
I mean, Little
Punch-Out...
Mac isn't getting a new game anytime soon.
Yes, he is. They're redoing when? Punch-Out.
What? They did that on the Wii, but I don't think they're doing it again.
From what I saw, whenever you clicked on his thing, it said, check out his new game.
I'm gonna look right now, because I'm curious.
I'm pretty sure they did...
I mean,
and even if it's not a new game, they're, you know, still advertising
yeah, but also,
their old one.
Also, the reason Little Mac was added was because he was the most requested character in the U.S., so, I mean, you gotta give
really?
Him that.
Really?
He was the, yeah, he was the most, he was like the, he was like, you know what, U.S., this is for you. U.S. representation. Which is, according to the polls they did. You know, plenty of other people wanted Ridley or King K. Rool or Mewtwo, but...
I can understand why they didn't put Ridley in. Because
yeah.
most
I
people
can't.
Know Ridley by his giant pterodactyl form.
Wait,
and that
he
would,
has another form?
Right.
Yes.
Oh.
Yes, but...
Well, there
Sakura
you go right there. There's a perfect example.
Mashed Potato
yeah.
Mashed Potato Samurai has stated many times size doesn't matter. I would never play as Ridley if he came in, to be honest, because I'm not even that big a Metroid fan. The only thing I don't understand is why did they tease him so much and then did nothing?
You know, we should
they
probably
teased
like,
him a lot.
Stop the video at this
yeah,
point.
Yeah, we need to pick this up in the next episode. Sorry for the ramblings, yeah. everyone. We do this sometimes.
I just really like Smash Brothers. and it's less
and
than a month away.
In the next one, probably some more rambles. Maybe we can change the topic to just Pokemon.
Oh.
Maybe
oh.
we should.
Oh!
And until then, goodbye, sir.
Oh.